Welcome back. We have a really special guest with us in the studio today as the National Novena ends today at the National Shrine of Our Lady of Good Help in Champion.
It's Michael O'Neill, and you may know him as the Miracle Hunter. Good morning to you.
Thanks. It's great to be here today.
Well, let's talk a little bit about why you're here. For those of us who aren't up to date on all our Catholic terminology, what is the National Novena?
So it's 9 days of prayer. So at the Shrine of Our Lady of Good Help, they've had speakers and prayers each and every day. And on this ninth day, I'll be the speaker. So I'm excited to be here in Champion.
And today's a very special anniversary, isn't it, in Champion?
Correct. It's the anniversary of the first vision of the Virgin Mary to Belgian farm worker Adele Bryce, who received three visions. But today is the anniversary of the first one. So it's kind of a big date for the Shrine here.
Sure. And you were here in 2010 when the Shrine was authenticated. Tell us about your role then.
Sure. So I was here with Relevant Radio. I do a radio show now with Relevant Radio. And so I was here for the live broadcast of that big event. And it was big because there have been cases throughout history like Lourdes, Fatima, Guadalupe. Those are big names for Catholics. But in the United States, there's only been one approved Marian apparition, one vision where the bishop said it was worthy of belief. And that's here in Champion, Wisconsin. So I was there on the date when the bishop made the announcement. So it was a big deal for me.
And what have you been doing this week?
So we've been filming for a new program coming out on EWTN. That's a new show called The Miracles of Champion, where we're going to look at those visions of Mary, the fire miracle of Peshtigo, and also the different healings that are being claimed even today.
Wow. Now, you touched on it briefly. The process for becoming that apparition site, not an easy thing, not taken lightly. Walk us through that.
Right, and in this case, the visions happened in 1859, so it took a long time for the bishop in 2010 to declare this. But there's actually a 1978 document which says that the local bishop is the one who can institute an investigation, but then it's his responsibility to find out that everything adds up. The facts add up, there's nothing wrong with the doctrine being proposed, and also that the person isn't crazy who's claiming these things. So all those things passed muster, and he made the decision that it was worthy of belief in the supernatural character of the event.
Wow. You know, you've been on the Dr. Oz show and several other national programs. Why is it important for us, you know, as a country, to see these kinds of things?
Well,
and be part of the mainstream?
Well, they're inspiring, aren't they? I think with all the negative news that's out there today, these stories of people's lives being changed through miracles is a big deal. And everybody is kind of touched by miracles in their own ways, whether they're small miracles or big ones. I think it's something that touches everybody.
Sure.
Let's talk a little bit about your series on EWTN called They Might Be Saints. What does it focus on?
So it looks at the lives of American saints or those who are on the path to sainthood. And you may or may not know this, but for every saint, there has to be two miracles that are found to show that they're with God in heaven interceding for the faithful. So it's a story about those saints, but also the great miracle stories of healings that have happened.
And I would imagine because some of these go way back in history, it's a lot of bookwork for you. What's your process in becoming the miracle hunter, I guess?
So I've got this website called miraclehunter.com where I document the church's history in investigating. And as you said, it goes back decades, centuries perhaps in some cases. And so I'd like to document that for people who have questions and they want to know what does the church say, what has happened in these cases, they can go to my site and check out just what happened.
Oh, you must have a lot of like really goosebump kind of moments in your job.
Well, it is the most fun job in the world, in my opinion. But yeah, getting to investigate miracles and find out these occasions where God is touching the world, that's a big deal for me and many people around the world.
I saw one of the clips of like a medical miracle that you were investigating, but there's a kind of a wide range of things that you investigate, right? Stigmata, incorruptibles, what's that?
So there's this phenomenon that's happened throughout history that there have been some saints in the Catholic Church whose bodies have not decayed, have not gone through the normal process. So it's kind of a way out there kind of thing. You don't have to believe it if you don't want to, of course, but there are cases where the bodies have been preserved perfectly. So it's a strange thing, but interesting.
Yeah.
I have a feeling I could spend quite a few hours at miraclehunter.com. Stories to read about. Thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for having me
Thanks
today.
For coming to the area.
Appreciate it.